guys, here's the latest mini that I just painted. You can see I made a mistake on the one tooth, though. This is such a small figure that I actually touched it up after seeing that on the video. Just a short tip to talk about with you guys. This, I believe, is from the Reaper miniature line, which, by all stretch of the imagination, is a lot cheaper than a GW. Typically $5.99 a figure, or some are cheaper. Some you can get in bigger lots. So there's a couple benefits. One, they're metal. So if you make a mistake or you want another shot at it, it's a lot easier to strip them. And the other thing with these figures is I got these three figures in on trades and I didn't pick them. Somebody else purchased them for whatever reason, either they like the sculpt or they wanted to use it in a D&D campaign. So it's completely out of my comfort zone, if you will, these three figures. Especially in Warhammer 40K, I would have never purchased these. But when they showed up, I thought they were extremely cool. So some of the techniques that I've applied to these three figures, there's only four Reaper figures I've ever painted, and one was that Toxanimer that I sent to Jedi Jim that forced me to paint outside the box. With Jedi Jim's wizard, first time I ever used object source lighting. This lady here, first time I've ever had that amount of skin to paint. And even this rat catcher here, there's so many different tones in the fantasy line of painting compared to what I've been painting with 40K. So, that being said, guys, my quick tip on if you want to become a better painter, paint different things. If you've been painting Space Marines for a couple of years and Orcs, get something completely different. Spend a couple dollars. It might be a little bit more of a pain to prep a metal model, but it's a heck of a lot easier to strip it if you want another shot at it. Whether I ever use these in a future D&D game or campaign, who knows, but I had a lot of fun painting them, and it forced me to paint outside the box. So hopefully that tip helps you guys. On that side note, I'm still looking for more Reaper minis just to force me to paint outside the box. So if anybody's got some lying around and they want to trade for 40K stuff or for me to buy them off them, just send me a PM. Thanks, guys. Hopefully this just gets you thinking. Bye-bye.